Good morning, students. So in this video, I'll continue chapter number 11, Force and Pressure. In last video, I had discussed the concept of pressure with you, that pressure is a force exerted per unit area, and how pressure and force and area varies with one another. After that, children, pressure, different activities are related with the pressure. So few of the activities we are going to discuss here. Pressure exerted by liquids and gases. So let's discuss few of the activities, how the pressure is exerted. First, let's see liquid exert pressure on the walls of a container. As in the first figure, we can see that liquid exert pressure on the walls of the container. In the second figure, we can see that liquid exert pressure on the bottom of a container. It depends upon the height of a liquid column. So the amount of water filled in this column, that much of the pressure is exerted. So let's see what is this first activity. So we have taken a tube and at the bottom we have just put a rubber balloon. Okay, and when we start filling water in that test tube or tube, whatever you have taken, the rubber balloon start becoming bigger in size, as you can see in this figure. So that depend. In first figure, I must tell you that the size of the bulge is smaller as the level of water is less here. And in the second figure, there is a more bulge. The balloon has become bigger because the water level is more in this figure. So we can say that liquid exert pressure on the bottom of the container, that depends upon the height of the liquid. So amount of water present in it will show that how much balloon will bulge. So I think you must have done this activity so many times. You used to fill the balloon with water. So as soon as we put water into the balloon, that depends upon the height of the liquid present in it. Second activity we can do, that liquid exert pressure sideways. Now this time, instead of bottom, we make a hole in the bottle on the sideways and just put a balloon here. So in the same way, when we start filling it with water, then what happens? In the same way as in first and second cases, the balloon becomes bulges. The water gets filled into the balloon. So it means either we make the hole at the bottom or either on the sideways, the pressure is exerted. So from this activity, it's clear that liquids exert pressure on the sideways. So children, this figure shows one more activity is there, that liquid exert pressure at the same height. So what to do in this activity? Easily you can do this activity at your home. We have to take any disposable plastic bottle. In any plastic disposable bottle, we have to make hole on the four sides. Fine. In this way, at the equal height. Suppose we have taken 4 cm from the bottom. So we had make a hole over there. Here we had made a hole and on the sideways we had made the hole. But you have to keep this in mind that the hole should be at the equal distance from the bottom. Equal height pe honi chahiye ye bottom se. And then what we have to do, just put that bottle under the water. And as soon as we switch on the tap, water start filling in it. And as the water reaches to the hole, water start coming out of the hole. And that water is falling at the same distances. If we watch for four holes, the water will fall in four holes in the same way. The distance at which the water is falling is same for the four holes. So this shows that liquid exert pressure at the same height. So children, these are the few of the activities which are showing that liquids exert pressure. In this way, we can say for the gases also. Gases also exert pressure. So many of the examples you have seen when we fill air in the balloon. See in the tire tube when the air is filled. In another way, we can fill the air in it. Or we can say that when we fill air or gas in these tubes, the pressure is exerted. So same way we can say that gases exert pressure on the walls of a container. As soon as we fill the air, that size of the object becomes bigger and bigger. Next comes the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means atmospheric pressure. Let's discuss first of the definition of atmospheric pressure. It's a pressure of our air around us. Atmospheric pressure is due to the weight of air. So we can check here the weight of air column of height of the atmospheric is, if the area is 10 centimeter into 10 centimeter, is as large as 1000 kilogram. So means air is also exerting a pressure. So children, here we can see an example of a rubber sucker. You must have seen rubber sucker, especially in cars. When we protect the car from the inside, we just put the shield to protect from sun. So that get attached with the rubber sucker. So when we attach it with the glass, it become very, very easy. Easily it gets stick to it. But when we have to remove it, then what happens? We have to apply much more force. Much more force we have to apply to remove it. How rubber sucker works? What happens to it? How it gets stick to the glass so easily? So children, rubber sucker, two things are there. Rubber sucker, you know, the surface is very, very smooth. It gets stick on the glass or on the smoother surface very, very easily. So in this, what happens? Atmospheric pressure exert from outside. And you know, when it gets stuck to the glass surface, the air get escape out of it. So it stuck tightly to the glass surface. And the, from outside, atmospheric pressure exert on it. So that's why rubber sucker gets stick tightly to the glass. So we can say that atmospheric pressure is a pressure of the air around us. So children, everywhere the air pressure is exerting. But did you feel any of the pressure? One side we are saying that air is exerting a pressure, and you know the air is present all around us. So why we are not feeling that pressure if air is exerting a pressure? So I think you must think about it. Why we are not get crushed under the atmospheric pressure? Why we are not feeling it? So children, the answer to this question is that you must have heard about the blood pressure. Inside our body, blood is also exerting a pressure. So that blood pressure which is present inside our body is exactly equal to the atmospheric pressure. So both are equal. So they affect the cancel the effect of each other. That's why we are not exerting any of the pressure from outside. Okay, I think I'm very, very clear with it. So this was a concept of atmospheric pressure. Here one diagram is there. So on the both sides, the horses are there which want to. This is like a tug of war. So this is a hollow sphere. Hollow sphere, two hemi hollow spheres are there. They are get attached with each other in such a way that the vacuum has created. Now the horses on both the sides, they are pulling it, but the force of horse is not enough to get it separate. So means the atmospheric pressure is exerting on it. So children, we can see that how much strong is the atmospheric pressure. So this was the concept of atmospheric pressure. I think you have understood the concept. Thank you.